All right, uniform motion problems. These are my favorite word problems. All right, so let's start with a little story. It's 12 p.m. Super Snail and Sergeant Salt. Not Super Snail, not Sergeant Salt. They're 12 inches apart, and they start traveling towards each other. Super Snail travels at 4 inches per minute. Sergeant Salt travels at 2 inches per minute. So they're not very fast. Okay, so here comes Super Snail, and it's 1, 2, 3, 4. That took him a minute to get to here. And Sergeant Salt, he does 2 inches per minute. So 1, 2, that's a minute. So after 1 minute, they would be here and here, still not together. So we're going to just, we don't want to sit here and wait and find out how long it's going to take for them to meet. So we make a little problem. So we know that Super Snail's distance is made by the formula rate times time. Same with Salt, rate times time. We know that his rate is 4. We don't know how long he's been traveling. Salt is 2. Same thing, T. And what we have to find now is, now what's the relationship between these two distances? So if you follow their distance, that right there is the total distance traveled by the salt. And that is the total distance traveled by the snail, right in here. That's D for the snail. That's D for the salt. Okay, and how far apart are they? They're 12 inches. So together, they have to travel 12 inches. If we have this situation where they're traveling towards each other, there's a total distance that's given, then their distances both have to add up to 12. So if we take the 4T and the 2T, we add them up, we have to get 12. And that gives us 2 minutes. So after 2 minutes, they would meet. Let's see if it's true. So this one does 4 inches every minute. So that's 1 minute. And then 1, 2, 3, 4. And 1, 2. So that's when they would meet right there. And it's true. 2 minutes. 1, 2, 1, 2. So on each problem, we're going to have two different items, two objects, and they're going to be traveling towards each other, away from each other, or in the same direction. So what we have to do is find the distance formula for each, and then find the relationship between those distances. That's it. And there's going to be a nice pattern. So let's try another one. So read the problem to yourself, and then see if you can figure it out what goes in where. So this is Sally, and that's why I have DS there. This is Jimmy. Okay. So Sally's rate is 1 foot per second. Jimmy's is 2. And the problem is asking when Jimmy starts the race. That means we have the T for Jimmy. So that's T for Jimmy. And all you have to do is ask yourself now, for Sally, did she have more or less time? We know it's a difference of 3 seconds, but did she have 3 seconds more or less? Well, since she started before him, she had 3 seconds more. This goes back to the same warm-up problem we did with James and Sylvia, where Sylvia had 30 minutes more because she left before James. It's the same exact setup, and that's all you have to do. So when you have a comparison of time like this, just ask yourself, did this person have more or less? And now we can just distribute. And there's your distances. Now, what's the relationship? Well, if Jimmy takes off after Sally, Sally already left, he's got to catch her. And we're asking, how long does it take for her to catch, him to catch her? Which means their distances are the same. So if we take our two distances, we set them equal to each other. This will give us an equation that we can easily solve. And it's 3. T is time, which is in seconds. So it's 3 seconds. It will take Jimmy 3 seconds to catch Sally. And that's it. All right, so these are the three different types you're going to have for our basic word problems that involve uniform motion. They will get a little bit trickier as you get to the very, very last problems in our section. But these are our basic setup. So if they're going towards each other, you add the two distances together to make that total distance. If they're going away from each other, you just do the exact same thing because they will travel some total distance from here to there. And if they're going in the same direction, it's usually when will they catch each other. So that's when they're equal. All right, so give this one a shot. I've already got the picture for you. All you have to do is fill everything in and then see what the relationship is. So hit pause and give it a shot. And there's the answer. So they gave us a nice little hint where it said same time. So if you know the time is the same, you can make t the same. And we just plug in our speeds, use the formula, and since they're going in opposite directions, there's a total distance given. So these two have to add up to that total distance. So we know that that's 85t, and that's 95t for our distances, and they have to add up to 315. All right, flip the page. Let's try another. Give that one a shot. Hit pause now and try it. Okay, and before you start this one, though, make sure that you simplify your time. And simplify your time. This is not minutes that we want. We want hours because this is miles per hour. And we have to make sure that they match. So now, give it a shot. All right, and that's how you should have filled it in. So those are your two distances. And now, what's the difference? What's the relationship between them? So since they're going in the same direction, you're going to set them equal. So set them equal and solve it. All right, so we should have the car is traveling at 36 miles per hour. But it's not asking for that. It's asking for the distance he travels to work. So you could plug it in here or here. I'm going to plug it in the first. So 0.5 times, this is our distance. 0.5 times 36. That's half of 36. So it's 18 miles. That's his distance to work. 18 miles. I'll give the next one a shot. All the way through, I'm not going to help at all this time. Just write the answer in about 2 seconds. All right, so you should have got 1.5 hours, and since they started at 1 p.m., that would give us a time of 2 o'clock, 2:30 p.m. All right, I think I got the idea, but I just want to do one more together just to make sure. All right, so this is how they should be done. Now, you're not going to even have this on your paper when you're doing these. You got to set them up all yourself. No more pictures. So two planes start from the same point and fly in opposite directions. So you have to draw the picture now. It's very important to get an idea of what the relationship is. So two planes fly in opposite directions. So we know it's the type where we're adding them up. And there it is, the total 1,400 miles apart. So we know that we're going to equal 1,400 at some point. Okay, the first plane is flying 50 miles per hour slower than the second plane. So we'll say plane one, plane two. And it's flying at 50 miles. The first plane is 50 miles per hour slower. That means we have to take it away. In 2.5 hours, so we're assuming they left at the same time, which they did. So 2.5 is our time. We use our formula. And then those two, the decimal, have to add up to 1,400. So solve it. And so we should get an x of 305 miles per hour. And that's for plane 2. So plane 2 is traveling at 305 miles per hour. And then plane 1 is traveling at 50 miles per hour slower, so 255 miles per hour. Right? And then now we just have to check it. It's the same way we've checked before. So we have this speed times the time, and this speed times the time, and we should have a total distance there. So if we have 305 miles per hour for 2.5 hours plus 255 miles per hour for 2.5 miles, that should give us a total distance of 1,400. Plug it in. $1,400. Checks out. And that's it. That's uniform motion. Thank you.